Chris Haynes of ESPN. I want to pick your brain about what you can tell me, what you think's going on in Cleveland right now. Tristan Thompson saying that if you're not communicating on defense, then sit your ass on the bench. Who's he talking about?
Double T, man. I love that guy. Look, I think he's talking to everybody in general. You know, I wouldn't be surprised that if that's a subtle shot on LeBron, at LeBron too. That's one thing I always respected from Double T is that we all know LeBron. Like LeBron, he'll go off on anybody. He'll show you up on the court. And I noticed that whenever he does that to Double T, sometimes Double T will take it, but sometimes you'll see Double T go right back off on LeBron while the cameras are rolling. Now, I haven't seen many players do that. And so I wouldn't be surprised if that's a subtle shot at LeBron, but obviously collectively they all need to do the same thing and follow his lead. And it's interesting. I covered that team for 2 years, covered the year they won that title. And it seemed like throughout the course of the season, they would always have their lumps. And it'd be lumps to where you feel like, man, they need to break this thing up. They need to go out and get somebody. But at the end of the day, towards the end of the season, Cavaliers will make repairs and they'll get it going. This season, I haven't seen this before. This is a circus season. It's been a circus in the postseason, and so I don't know what to say about that squad over there. You know, they definitely, if they don't get Game 3, you know, obviously it's over. But I've never seen this from a LeBron James team, especially LeBron James team since he's came back to the Cavaliers.
Well, then he must be sitting there in the back of his head. Last one for you here, Chris, is how the next few games plays out, plays into his decision on July 1st. How can you read those tea leaves for me? Best you can.
Well, look, man, I'm telling you right now, I personally believe that his mind is probably already made up. And I know a lot of people will disagree with that and say he's not going to make a decision until after. I think his mind is pretty much already made up on, you know, not where he's going to go, but, you know, that it's hard for me to see him back in Cleveland, Rich. That's just it. And I think even if he is able to – I don't know. If he's able to get past Boston, it's difficult to see it, but if he's able to do that, I just don't see him that team matching up well against Golden State or the Rockets. And ultimately, for LeBron, it's all about championships. So if he feels he doesn't have the roster that can compete for a title and not just compete, you know, win the damn thing, he's not going to be invested. And so I think his mind may be made up as far as that he's leaving Cleveland. So. These games really don't matter in the grand scope of things. But I definitely – the one part that plays in the favor of the Cavs is that there aren't a lot of teams out there with cap space and with the situation that's desirable for LeBron. So they have that in his favor. But, look, I think it's ultimately going to end with LeBron taking off. Where, I don't know. But, you know, definitely the way they're ending this postseason or appear to be ending this postseason – it's definitely not going to bode well for the Cavs.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.